Namaste. On behalf of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Dr. Kulpati K. Munshi Institute of Art and Culture, it is my pleasure and privilege to welcome all of you for today's special function. It is a function in the sense you will be able to see a docu-film, docu-drama it is called specifically, because we are projecting the life and times of Kulpati Munshi ji right from his birth to death. And his Amaratva also is being included in the film. There is a saying called Prithyorma Amritangamaya. Even after one passes away, their life and times always continues to inspire millions and millions of people across the globe. And one such great personality, as you all know, the founder of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Kulpati K. Munshi. Today, we are presenting this docu-drama in the direction of Dr. Rajaram, who is also a theatre exponent. And nearly 100 artists have taken part in this wonderful show. And you will be presenting it in two parts as it has been announced in the invitation card. And today I have the pleasure to invite Honorable Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya to kindly inaugurate this show to mark the birth anniversary of Kulpati K. Munshi. This birthday is 134th birthday of Munshi ji, and during his lifetime, he has been able to present himself in such a way where he is a role model for everyone. And we are grateful to Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya. You are going to hear him during his inaugural address. And we are very grateful to him. He has been a guide for all of us all through in our activities. I also thank Dr. Dilip Surana, who is the Chairman Managing Director of the Micro Labs. He is also Vice Chairman of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, and he has also been kind enough to inaugurate the docu-film. And he will also have a few words as before the inauguration. And as usual, our ever inspiring chairman, Sri K.G. Raghavan, I invite him for this show, and I request him to deliver the welcome address.
Dr. K. Munshi, the lawyer, the jurist, author, literator, statesman, and above all, the founder of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, was born over 135 years ago. His contribution in every field of his activity throughout his life is awe-inspiring. While he built several institutions, he himself was an institution. He is a standing example of immortality of life, given the indisputable position that life is not eternal. To Munshi ji, social and cultural history of India transgressed geographical, ethnic, and all other boundaries and was exemplary of the statement that the world is one family, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. To him, the soul of India rested in its immutable culture, and therefore he was not content at striving for political freedom alone for India. The soul of India had to be liberated. Towards that end, he conceived of an institution apolitical in nature and unshackled by the limitations of religion, caste, gender, and race. That was Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, which he founded a good 10 years before the country attained political independence. Bharatiya Vidya to him was universal in character and embodied and accepted within itself noble thoughts from all sources, which became the motto of the Bhavan, Ano Bhadraha Kritavo Yantu Vishwataha. Today, Bhavan has transgressed beyond merely propagating the culture of India, but has entrenched itself in providing secular education based on Indian values and traditions. Bhavan has secured to itself a place of pride in the committee of the world's non-governmental organizations. It is important that such persons as Munshi ji should be showcased to the world, more particularly to the younger generation, who have not seen him, so that the personality of such persons can be an inspiring and guiding spirit or a beacon for all. It is with this objective in view that the Bangalore Kendra of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan embarked upon this project of making a biopic on the life and times of Dr. K.M. Munshi. This is the first movie that has been made within the Bhavan across the country. The task was challenging. The diversity in the personality of Munshiji had to be presented without taking away the spirit of each aspect of his living. Each of the important events of his life had a message to convey, and that message had to be conveyed in an unalloyed manner. Every effort has been made to present the life and message of Dr. Munshi in that manner. The task, though, was daunting, was supported by dedication. On behalf of the Bhavan, I thank each and everyone who devoted his or her time for the successful accomplishment of this endeavor. Everyone has acted beyond the call of duty for the love of the cause. Personally, I felt humbled that I was assigned the role of enacting the part of Munshiji in the later part of his life. It was challenging, but at the same time, inspiring. The responsibility of depicting Munshiji as he was at the later part of his life, devoted to the cause of propagating the objects and aims of Bhavan, was indeed fulfilling, and I consider myself fortunate at being able to do so, hopefully justifying the faith reposed in me. It is indeed our good fortune that we have with us Honorable Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya, former Chief Justice of India, to release the biopic on the life and times of Dr. K.M. Munshi. Justice Venkatachalaya, M.N.V.J., as we affectionately call him, is himself an institution, and it is most appropriate that we have him today to dedicate for public exhibition this biopic on another institution, namely Dr. K.M. Munshi. On behalf of the Bhavan, I sincerely thank him and express our gratitude for this kind gesture. He has been unfailingly supportive of the Bhavan at Bangalore in all its endeavors and has blessed us on innumerable occasions by his guidance, advice, and personal presence. With these few words, I shall rest and request Sri M.N.V.J. to release this biopic for public viewing. I also thank the sponsors of this project, Messrs. Micro Labs Limited, and in particular Mr. Dilip Surana, Vice Chairman of the Bangalore Kendra of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, for their magnanimity and support. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Mr. Raghavan, for your welcome address. Now may I request Honorable Justice Sri M.N. Venkatachalaya ji to kindly inaugurate the film and also say a few words on this very special occasion. He knew Munshi very well, and I am sure his views and words have a lot of influence on the younger generation, so that they can have a lot of takeaway in his speech.
Today, we are celebrating the 134th birthday and honoring the auspicious and precious memory of a remarkable Indian whose contribution to the nation and its civilizational inheritance was immense. He left behind a treasure house of cultural and moral values. He was Sri K.M. Munshi. He was a freedom fighter, political leader, eminent lawyer, author, and more than all, his contribution to the cultural renaissance of India could be said to be the largest single contribution. The Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, which Munshiji founded in the year 1938, is a shining monument to Munshiji's dedication to the promotion of the cause of India's cultural values. Munshiji was a versatile and many-splendored personality. He rose to high positions in his political career. He was member of the Constituent Assembly. He was the Home Minister of the then state of Bombay, Agent General of India in Hyderabad State. He was Union Minister for Agriculture and Food. He was Governor of Uttar Pradesh. More than all, he was a passionate social reformer. All these positions Munshiji held with great distinction. But what was dazzling in his personality was his immense pride in the cultural resources and richness, diversity, and myriad manifestations of its effulgence. Art, dance, drama, music, poetry, literature, painting, with their enormous diversities, possessed him and enthralled him. The now world famous Bharati Vidya Bhavan was his brainchild, standing out as a monument to the spirit of Munshiji's spirit of India. The title the Kulapati was his legitimate entitlement. Munshiji was a brilliant and successful lawyer and appeared in many important cases. As an author, editor, and spirit behind many research publications, Munshiji's name stands out as a pioneer in the publication relating to the historical, cultural, and religious literature of this country. His editorship of the monumental work, The History and Culture of the Indian People, was the statement and affirmation of his faith in the antiquity and richness of India's history. Those volumes tell the story of India. Likewise, Munshiji's Krishnavatara and companion works are his tribute to this religion and spirituality of this country. Amongst his many other writings, Pilgrimage to Freedom, End of an Era, hold a mirror to the great events of Indian history. Bhavan's journal is again a precious publication. Speaking of this great scholar, savant, patriot and intellectual, President Rajendra Prasad's tribute is worth recalling. He said, among generations of leaders who emerged around Mahatma Gandhi, the greatest versatility was that of Munshi. He was the most versatile of all the leaders. To Munshi, I bow to Munshi in reverence and admiration for his versatility. So does the whole nation bows to this great son of India. I thank you very much for this invitation.
It is always our pleasure and privilege to have Dr. M.N. Venkatachalya, former Chief Justice of India, with us. And he has inaugurated the film and blessed us. And we are ever grateful to him. And we offer our pranams on this very special occasion. Friends, it is my pleasure now to invite Dr. Dilip Sarana, Chairman and Managing Director of Microlabs, and also the Vice Chairman of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, to kindly address the gathering on this special occasion. And he has been kind enough to sponsor an institute at the Bharati Vidya Bhavan known as Kulapati KM Institute of Art and Culture. Through this institute, we present lot of multiple programs connected with art and culture.
Today marks the 134th birth anniversary of the founder of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, late Sri Kanhaiyalal Maneklal Ji Munshi Ji. I am pleased to be inaugurating Amar Munshi Ji, a two-part document drama produced by Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Bangalore, on the life and times of Kulapati Munshi Ji. This play comprehensively focuses on the many aspects of Munshi Ji's life, be it his stint as a lawyer, freedom fighter, literateur, politician or environmentalist. I recommend to the younger generation that they watch this play to know about a magnanimous personality who strived to protect and promote our culture, heritage and the incredible forms of art we are blessed with. We at Microlabs are glad to have sponsored this incredible play through Dr. K.M. Munshi Ji Art and Culture Institute Wing of the Bhavan. I wish Bhavan Bangalore all the best. Thank you.
Dear viewers, I thank Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya Ji, former Chief Justice of India, for having inaugurated this film on this very special occasion. I also take this opportunity to thank Dr. Dilip Sarana, Chairman Managing Director of Microlabs, for having presided over this function, and also our Chairman, Sri K.G. Raghavan, for having been present virtually from the US and given the welcome address. And I welcome you all for this two-part docudrama. The first episode will be aired right now, and the second episode is at 6 o'clock in the evening. I'm sure that you will enjoy the same. Kindly send your views after viewing the whole program. Namaskar. Namaste. It is my pleasure and privilege to welcome all of you to celebrate 133 birthday of our Kulpati Munshiji at Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Bangalore, Kendra. As you all know, for the last over 50 years, Bhavan's Bangalore Kendra is working tirelessly to take forward the vision of Kulpati Munshi through its various activities. We thought we should celebrate this birthday in a very special and unique manner. We thought of bringing the life and the works of Kulpati in the format of a theatre and also make it that as a film so that the large number of audience can see or watch the life of Kulpati Munshi, his vision and mission throughout his life and what he stood for this country and so on and so forth about the personality of Kulpati Munshi, who was versatile and he was a living legend during his lifetime. And in this program, my friends, about 100 artists, technicians have worked over 3 months tirelessly to bring the best in us to present for younger generation the life of Kulpati Munshiji and his message. This program titled Amar Munshiji is brought to you by Kulpati K. Munshi Institute of Art and Culture, which has been sponsored by Micro Labs and its chairman, Sri Dilip Sunna, who is also the chairman of Micro Labs and also the vice chairman of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Bangalore. And I am glad our good friend and also a renowned theatre director, Sri Rajaram, has taken the full responsibility of producing this place. Of course, he has got a great experience behind him. Similarly, we have Dr. K. Nagalakshmi Rao. She has been choreographed the dance portions wherever it is necessary and with her students. And of course, our own Satvik, Ravindra Satvik, is more known as. He and his team have worked tirelessly. Number of hours, I have lost the count how many hours they have done the work, and they have been able to edit the film and present it today on the YouTube as a national premiere. Namaskar.
ज्योत जगाना अमृतमय Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan is an organization which aims to spread Indian culture throughout the world. It's also vibrant in the field of education, spreading Indian culture across the world. It has 119 branches in India and 7 worldwide, spreading Indian culture through 367 institutions.
It was December 30, 1887. A baby was born in the house of Maniklal Munshi and Tapi Ben of Baroch in Gujarat.
Dad, Dad, I think the baby is born.
Oh!
Let's see the cute baby.
Come.
Sarkar, it's a baby boy. Baby's very cute.
What?
Baby boy? Thank God. Oh, thank God. Take this gift for this good news. Come. Congratulations, Tobi. Oh, what is he doing?
Look how cute he is. I'm so happy.
Look how soft is the little foot, hand, face, and skin. Isn't it, Ma?
Yes. You were also like that when you were a baby.
Now look at your skin. How rough it is, like a donkey's skin. No, it is just because of cold.
No, it is donkey's skin.
It is because of cold.
Let's not make much noise here. Huh? By the way, where is our little girl?
Standing there behind the door.
Why is she standing there?
Now look
at her. What are you doing, little daughter? Come. See your little brother.
Wow, he's like butter in Krishna's hand. What should we call him, Dad?
What is that? He is like butter in Krishna's hand. Then, why don't you call him Krishna, Kanhaiya? What do you say, Tapi?
Oh, it's so cute. I'm so happy. Krishna, Kanhaiya, Krishna.
Ah, he is Kanhaiya Lal, Maniklal Munshi.
Oh, Kanhaiya Lal, Maniklal Munshi?
Ah.
child's health was a matter of concern in his early years. He was a fussy eater. Sometimes it took the combined efforts of his mother and three sisters to make him eat.
I have made your favorite sweet. She can't come.
No, I don't want to eat. I want to play now.
Come, Kalu. Eat little.
Wait, no, Mom. Catch him.
Okay.
Look, catch him.
Kalu, come here.
Kalu, come. Kalu, come.
Oh, no. It has spilled out on me. It is sticky. I have to clean it.
Time to school. Come out and eat it.
You're so mischievous, Kalu. Eat. Eat a little, Kalu.
Come, Shifi Bhai, it's getting late for school.
Oh, Kalu, wait for me.
Come, Shifi Dalpa.
By the way, where is your bodyguard? He promised to bowl me today.
Who? Shifi?
Yes.
Mohammad Shafi playing cricket? I cannot imagine that Mohammad Shafi playing cricket. He's so hard as a rock. But he can try. Here he is.
Little Sarkar. Sarkar asked me to give this book to you.
Oh, Three Musketeers?
Oh, Kanu. You always do the same thing. Whenever you get a book, you never come to play.
Little Sarkar doesn't pay much attention to the game. Come, I will bow.
Yes. Yeah, I'm expecting speed and spin ball. I have to practice them.
Dalpa, here it is.
Yes. Kanu. Oh, Kanu, get me the ball.
No, it's not here.
It's there only, Kanu. Get it.
Take this.
Oh, Kanu, you threw the ball that side. We are here. Waste of time asking you about the ball. No, Shafi Bhaiya, let's close the match for the day.
Little Sakar, come on, let's go to school. Come, Dalpa.
Yes.
Shantakaram Bhujagashayanam Padmanabham Suresham Vishwadharam Gagana Sadrusham Meghavarnam Shubhangam Lakshmikantam Kamalanayanam Yogi Rudyanagamyam Vande Vishnu Bhavabhayaharam Sarvalokaikanatham.
The Artagnan arrives in Paris. The three best musketeers are Athos, Porthos, and Aramis. The three musketeers plus the Artagnan happily engage the guards that beat them.
Ha! Hu! Ha! Hu! Ha! Hu! Ha! Hu! Ha! Hu! Ha! Hu!
Soundly. Now three musketeers have one more friend.
Four friends. One for all and all for
one.
There are several stories of friendship in the Puranas. Have I told you the story of Krishna and Sudhama?
No, Ma. You are going to recite an akhyan?
Yes.
Good.
Dalpak, can you sing a Krishna song for us?
Okay, Kaki.
Govardhana Girdhara Govinda Gokula Palaka Paramananda Govardhana Girdhara.
Very good. Krishna and Sudhama were the disciple of the great sage Sandipani.
Tapi Ben would regale her son with akhyans, that is, Puranic verses in Gujarati and tales from the Ramayana, Mahabharata and the Bhagavad Gita whenever she had an opportunity. Meantime, her two elder daughters who were married very early were widowed at a young age and Tapi Ben would often go to stay with them, leaving Kanhaiya with his father.
Haji.
Oh, Tapi, tell me.
Please see that Kanu has not only books to read, but plenty to eat.
Don't worry. I will take care of him. Don't worry, Tapi.
Kanu, don't give trouble to your father. Eat well.
Okay, Ma. When will you be back?
I'll be back in another 2 or 3 months.
Tapi, I will take care of him. You don't worry. Please take care of the daughters. At small age, they are widows. We have to give them moral support, Tapi. You don't worry. I will take care of Kanhaiya. Shafi?
Shafi?
Ah. You may assist her. Tomorrow, I am taking him to collector's office. You may proceed now. Take care. Kanhaiya?
Stop.
Why are you stopping us?
You should get down from the cart and start walking towards the office. It's Sahib's order.
Sahib's order?
Yes.
Then no issues. We will walk up to the office. Kanu, you please be seated here. Okay? I'll be back in 30 minutes. In the meanwhile, you keep reading your favorite book. Okay?
Okay.
I'll be back soon.
Does he think he's superior just because he has white skin? How dare he, you great father, the noblest of men. I would have turned around and gone home, but father is too duty conscious.
In his diary, Munshi reveals that he cried whole night. The incident aroused strong emotions in him, even years afterwards. Munshi was not only interested in reading, but he was also interested in theater. Theater groups used to visit Bharuch 3 to 4 months in a year.
Kanu! Oh, Kanu, it's getting late for the play.
Coming, Dalpat.
Yes.
Premchandrika is the best they have ever seen.
The same group is performing the day after tomorrow also. Will you come?
I would have loved to come, but father won't let me.
Your father invites troops to perform here, looks after them, but somehow he doesn't like you to see too many plays. Why is it so, Kanu?
I don't know.
It's fine. Now let's go to the play.
The play would start 9 in the night and stretch up to dawn next day.
Mom, what the play, father?
Kanu, your father is not feeling well.
Once upon a time, I was so proud of my health. But I suppose the age affects us all.
Sarkar?
Oh.
Sarkar.
Shafiq.
Some people from your office want to meet you.
Oh, is it?
Yes, sir.
Please ask them to come in.
Namaste, Munshiji.
Namaste, namaste. Tell me.
Sir, we have come here to explain the current situation on food stock and storage.
We have to make sure that we have got sufficient stock of food grains.
Yes, sir, yes. As we know, this is due to failure of summer monsoon. over Western and Central India.
Uh-huh.
It has affected a population of 59.5 million people.
Is it?
Yeah. This famine is acute in Central Province and Barar, the Bombay Presidency, and also in many other places, sir.
Oh, oh, oh. Sir, in addition to that, the small areas of the Bengal Presidency, Madras Presidency are acutely affected by the famine, sir.
Are there any mortalities?
Yes, sir. I'll read the report for you.
Please.
As on today, approximately 120,000 mortality cases are reported in Bombay Presidency and in Deccan Plateau.
What? 120,000?
Yes.
Oh, we have to work hard. We have to work very hard on this.
We will take care of everything, Munshi ji.
Sir, you must rest, sir.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Anything from my side?
Yes. Thanks, sir. Please take care.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, God.
Father, why do we have this famine so frequently?
Kanaya, it is partly due to wrath of a god and mostly due to our own inefficiency. Perhaps when you grow up, you may work out a solution for the shortage of food grains. Ha ha ha. Now, let's think of your marriage.
Father, marriage? Now, can't it wait?
Kannu, every father wants to see his son getting married. Hope you don't disappoint me.
Manek Lal was plunged into despair, but not dare enough to go against his father's wishes. So he married a girl his father chosen for him.
Her name was Ati Lakshmi. She was 9 years old. Kanaya Lal Munshi was 13. Following tradition, she would join him only when she turned 12.
Manek Lal's father wanted his son to go into civil services. He was overjoyed when he passed his matriculation in his first attempt.
Kanaya, Kanu, I am so happy. I am so happy that you obeyed my words like Lord Sri Ramachandra. Now you have attained Grihastha Ashram. And in academics, you have passed in the very first attempt. And I want you to complete civil service examination too.
Pa, it is all with your blessings.
It's always there, my son.
Pranal Desai, we have been hearing a lot about Congress and their leaders like Dadabhai Navroji and Feroz Shah Mehta. What do you think of them?
They are voices of discontent. The government should listen. Tom Paine says that when government cannot uphold the fundamental rights of people, people have every right to rise up against the government.
Tom Paine?
Yes, author of Rights of Man. You should read it. I'll lend you my copy.
Thanks.
By the way, have you read John Stuart Mill's quote on liberation?
John Mill?
The man behind the Britain Liberal Party Foundation. He says, every man has self-respect over his own mind and body. So neither society nor the state should put any restrictions on his behavior, conduct or utterances unless his behavior or utterances hurt someone else.
Bold statement. And I am in sympathy with him.
Why, Kanaya?
But if a man from the lowest strata of the society were to draw water from a commonwealth and upper caste members objected to him. So now, who would be hurting whom, PK?
Good question. Mill had something to say about the tyranny of society. According to him, society through control of behavior and morality is an unelected force that can do horrific things.
Yes, yes. Horrific things are done in our society because of caste.
Yes, we need an upheaval like the French Revolution to rid us of distinctions caused by caste, color and make all men equal.
PK, you are amazing. Even I need to study a lot like you and gain knowledge on politics and other subjects.
Hey Kanaya, we are organizing a debate on Shivaji's conquest. Would you like to participate?
Certainly. Napoleon Bonaparte has always been my favorite hero from history. But I admire Shivaji too.
But is it possible for me to debate on stage?
Kano, don't worry. You can certainly take part.
Yes. You admire Napoleon, but you forgot his famous quote. Impossible is a word to be found only in the dictionary of fools.
Work on Shivaji's life, my friend. You'll definitely succeed.
Yes, Shivaji is an inspiring soul.
If a tree that is not a highly elevated living entity can be so tolerant and merciful and give sweet mangoes even when hurt by anyone, being a king, should I not be more merciful and tolerant?
Wow, what a quote and what personality Shivaji was.
Come on, let's all go to the college.
Yes, come, yes. Come on.
That was a wonderful debate. For the next debater, I welcome Kanaya Lal Munshi on the stage.
Friends, today I am here to speak about Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji Maharaj. We are told that Shivaji Maharaj was given a sword, sword by Mother Bhavani.
Kanu, speak louder.
Oh God, how thin my voice sounds. Friends, can we believe such a thing in this day and age? Mother Bhavani swore Shivaji Maharaj.
Don't get scared, Kanu.
but all are same, same.
Kanu, speak louder.
I forgot what words were switched. I forgot what to tell. Friends, I'm sorry. I apologize for discontinuing.
Kanu, don't go. Kanu.
18th session of Congress at Ahmedabad in 1902. Kanaya Lal went to the session with his father. The mesmerizing speech by Mr. Surendranath Banerjee made him to think about patriotism.
My dear Indians, it is the Congress of United India, of Hindus and Mohammedans, of Christians, of Parsis and of Sikhs, of those who would reform their social customs and those who would not. Here, we have built a platform where people can bury their social and religious differences. Our country needs sacrifices. For our nation, for our people, we come together as one. Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Thank you.
What a speech by Mr. Surendranath Banerjee. He spoke so forcefully, Father. Didn't it move you?
He has got his ideas. But I cannot sympathize with him. Because I have eaten the salt of Sarkar, the British government.
Father, does the British government that pays you bring money from England? Kanaya?
Mr. Surendranath Banerjee's speech not only arose patriotic fervor in Kanaya Lal, but also made him to think his shortcomings as a public orator. So, he wanted to become a powerful speaker like Mr. Banerjee. He started training his voice by speaking loudly in secluded places.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. Huh?
Friend,
Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him.
His strenuous training paid him off. He became a skilled member of his college debating team. The oratorical skills he developed helped him in his later life too.
Kanu, there is a sad news for you.
Why, PK? What happened?
Hope all are well.
There is a sad news about your father.
Huh? Oh my God.
How to console my mother? He was the strength to my family. Oh, Father.
Console, my dear friend. Console.
How are you, Ma?
I'm fine, Bhai. How are you? Have you overcome from your father's death?
I'm trying to overcome, Ma. Ma, I have decided to give up studies and I'll take up a job.
No. You will do nothing of that sort. Father has left some money. I will sell my jewelry and list everything so that we have enough to get by. The servant will have to go, but I have asked my Mama Shafi to stay on. Do not worry, Varun, Bhai. Don't worry. Don't lose your courage. We will manage.
Okay, Ma. Ma, I need to make up my mind on studies. I love writing stories and I am interested in literature. I will work on that parallelly. Father was keen that I become proficient in English and qualify for ICS. Yes, I must live up to his expectations.
You have to pass on your studies.
Dalpat, look here. Kanu, be quiet. This is library. Sit down. What is the matter? Why are you so excited?
Look here, Dalpat. My article on Dayananda Saraswati has been published in the college magazine.
Congratulations, Kanu. Kanu, you admire Swami Dayananda Saraswati, don't you?
Yes, Dalpat. He was the one who gave us the plan for going back to freedom of Vedic times. No caste distinctions, no untouchability, equality for women, use of Sanskrit.
Yes, he also made us think that without this freedom, it was impossible for any social and economic reconstruction.
True, very true. Dalpat, what is the biggest news today?
Kanu, war broke out between Japan and Russia and ended in resounding defeat for Russia. An outcome had sent shockwaves around the world. Kanu, I have to complete Swami Dayananda Saraswati's book on Veda. I'll meet you later.
Okay, Dalpat.
Oh, look there. Acharya Aurobindo sir has come.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Sir, for the first time, an Asian people had defeated a major European power.
Yes. That is the biggest news. Kanaya, have you seen our country's map? See, here it is. This is our Bharat. It's towns, cities, lakes, rivers, mountains, form her physical body. Her children are her nerves, big and small.
her literature and culture are her memory and speech. Their vitality is her life. Concentrate on this Bharat as a living mother.
Sir, how do I develop such a concentration?
Have you read Vivekananda? He has written books on yoga. Take this Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Go through this carefully. You will be able to develop and control your senses.
Definitely, sir. I will read this. Thanks for the book, sir.
Very good. I'll meet you people later.
Thank you, sir.
Kanu, I'll meet you later.
Okay, Dalpat.
Yogascha Chitta Vritti Nirodaha. Yoga is restraining the mind stuff, Chitta, by taking various forms, Vrittis. Yogena Chittasya Padena Vacha Alam Sharirasya Cha Vaidyakena Yopam Karotam Pravaram Munina Patanjalim Pranjali Rana Tosmi.
Ma, I've graduated.
Oh, Kanu, good news. Very great news. Wait, wait, I'll bring some sweets for you.
Okay, Ma.
Have it, Kanu. Kanu.
Ma.
What do you want to do next?
Ma, father would have sent me to England to study and qualify for ICS. But that's out of question now. I feel so lost without him, Ma. Perhaps I must take up law.
Law? Kanu, law runs in the blood of the Munshis. Your great grandfather, your grandfather, eminent lawyers. Your uncle is a lawyer. But you had to go to Bombay to study.
Yes, Ma. I want to study at Elphinstone College.
Oh, you stay with the uncles. I'm sure they will be happy to have you.
Sure, Ma. We'll stay with them. Ma, even my friend Dalpat is also there.
Oh, very good, Kanu.
Ma. Dalpat, these films and squalors and crowds are too much for me in Bombay.
Kanu, that's the ugly side of life here. You have to get adjusted to it.
Yes, at present I have to adjust.
What you won't get here is the comfort and security which you are used to at home in Baroch.
Haha, I can manage without all that. What I would like is a little more privacy, slightly better food, and an occasional visit to theatre.
Are you joking, Kanu? We are living in Bombay. You can't expect any privacy here. The two in Charles, highly crowded city. Theatre is out of focus, Kanu.
Yes, I know, Dalpat. All that costs money and money which I don't have. Dalpat, I really don't know how mother is managing.
Kanu, your law classes are held in afternoons. So, you must be free the whole morning, right?
Yes, Dalpat, I'm free in the morning.
Then, why don't you take up a part-time job?
A part-time job?
Yes.
Dalpat, how do I go about finding one?
Kanu, don't worry. I know a newspaper printing firm. You can have your job as part-time proofreader in the daily newspaper.
So kind of you, my friend. The money helps me to meet my part of my expenses.
Yes. Come, let's go.
Yes.
Kanaya gradually adapted to Bombay City, but he was accompanied by restlessness and self-doubt. He was always hard up for money.
Kanaya? What is this, Kanaya?
Sir, you cannot do proper proofreading.
There are so many spelling mistakes and grammatical errors.
Is this the way to do proofreading?
Sir, I'm sorry.
If you don't improve, you'll be removed.
I'm sorry, sir. I'll look after this. I'm sorry, sir. This won't repeat again.
Kanu, what happened? Why are you so sad?
Dalpat, am I doing the right thing in taking up law?
What happened, Kanu? Why are you feeling so low and stressed out?
Do I have the right temperament, Dalpat? Will my poor health be an obstacle?
Oh, you stuck in managing hectic proofreading job and LLB, is it?
Yes, Dalpat. Perhaps I should have stuck for father's plan for me to join ICS. It may not be too late even now.
Don't you have any alternative for that?
Another alternative would be to do Master of Arts in History. You know, studying history would be a joy.
Yes.
How I wish I had someone to advise me.
Why don't you write a letter to mother? I'm sure she is the right person who can understand you very well.
Yes, Dalpat. But I'm looking for somebody who will fight with me or yell at me if I'm on a wrong track. Mother is too caring and supportive. She accepts almost any decisions I take. Dalpat, I'm feeling low because I couldn't complete LLB in past 2 attempts. How can I convey this to my family?
How about your wife, Kanu?
Aunty Lakshmi is too devoted to me. She too accepts almost anything I do, uncomplainingly, without questioning. She's a wonderful person, you know. But we are on different levels intellectually.
Different levels intellectually? I didn't understand.
Ma, I've given it a great deal of thought. I want to study further to become an advocate, and I want to fight for justice in courts.
Kanu, that means another last day in Bombay.
Yes, Ma.
Kanu, Ma. But this time, I'm not letting you go alone. You need someone to look after you, cook for you, and take care of your house.
Kanu, Aunty Lakshmi will come with you.
Okay, Ma. As you wish.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Come, we'll arrange books.
Yes, yes. Lakshmi, this chawl is newly built. We have rented 2-room house. How do you like it?
It's wonderful. For the first time, we are alone. I'll take good care of you.
Yes, we need to arrange the house from the beginning.
I will do that. I have bought old furniture and utensils from Baroj.
So kind of you, Lakshmi. You are so good to me. Let's start our new life here.
Kanu, Kanaya, are you there?
Come in, Maya. Please sit.
Thank you.
Lakshmi,
huh?
Come here.
This is Chandrashankar, famous Gujarati writer.
No, Babi. He is joking. I have not written anything great to be famous. By the way, even I too stay in same chal, Babi.
Welcome, Maya. I'll arrange tea.
Oh. Kanaya, what happened? You said that you are starting new write-ups.
Yes, yes. But I not yet started.
Okay.
I'm still studying. I want to write something new kind of stories. Uh-huh. Something different. I don't want to write like... Oh. Please have it.
Kanaya, now I am going to Mandal, our Gujarati literary club. Famous Gujarati poets and critics are accompanying there. Even you two join me.
Sure, sure. We'll go.
Yeah.
Lakshmi, I'll be back in the evening.
Okay, ji.
Namaste, Bhabhi. We'll meet again.
No other book has had as great an impact on society like Govardhan Ram's Saraswati Chandra.
Yes, you are right.
Definitely on Gujarati society.
Govardhan has such a profound understanding of human nature. Kanaya, you know, Govardhan too started out as a lawyer.
Yes, I know. I am familiar with his life and works.
Kanaya, tell me, have you written anything on your own?
When I was studying for my LLB, I wrote a few pieces for English journal. I have got article published in Hindustan Review, East and West, and even in Indian Ladies magazines.
Kanaya, I think I have read one of your English articles in East and West about Somnath.
Yes.
Tell me, Kanaya. Tell me completely about Somnath Temple.
I saw the temple as it was in 1024. Spire rising to the sky. Mighty acharyas, kings, lying their heads at the doorstep of sanctum. Desecrated, burnt and battered, and it still stood firm. A monument to our humiliation and ingratitude. Chandrashankar, I can scarcely describe the burning shame which I felt on the early morning as I walked on burnt floor of the once hallowed Sabha Mantapa littered with broken pillars and scattered stones. Lizards slipped in and out of their holes at the unfamiliar steps. And oh, to shame of it, an inspector's horse tied there, nailed. At my approach, sacrilegiously, impertinence, rudeness.
It's okay, Kanaya. Relax. Now tell me, Kanaya, have you written anything in Gujarati? First, you start writing in Gujarati.
Yes, you should write in Gujarati.
Listen. If Govardhan Ram Tripathi could write his masterpiece Saraswati Chandra in Gujarati, also a very readable book like Scrapbook in English, why can't I do the same?
Sir, namaste.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Please have your seat.
Namaste. Kanaya, meet. Great Gujarati poet and critic, Mr. Narasingha Rao Bholanath Divetiya.
Namaste, sir. It's an honor to me, sir.
Gujarati literature needs a young blood like you. Young man, I want to see more writings from your pen.
Definitely, sir. All I needed is your encouragement. I would like to revive not only Gujarati literature, but also Gujarati pride. Our people must be made aware of our great heritage, sir. We need to strive for the Gujarati Asmita.
Gujarati Asmita?
Asmita?
Yes.
Good. Good. Keep it up. Keep it up.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Munshi Bilakshu Bhargava Vamsha. Bhargava Parushurama. He is the son of Jamadagni, who is the proudest of warrior priests. Here, Bhargava Purusharama arrives in Bhruvashram.
Mm-hmm.
My salutation to Guru Jamadagni.
Welcome, my son Bhargava.
Father, what happened to Bhrugu Ashram? Why it is deserted?
I am collapsed, my son.
Your mother went to live with Gandharvas.
No! I don't believe this.
Even I have failed to give any swift punishment to that erring woman.
Is that true, father? Then I will take the action.
You are my true son. True Bhargava. The law of Bhrugavamsha is stillness. The erring wife must die. The Bhargava clan should always be pure. Pure!
If that is the case, she is punishable. I have enforced this against other women. Now it is my Amba's turn. If she has committed that mistake, definitely I will punish her. Yes, father. The Bhargava's clan always should be pure. Should be pure.
Yes, Bhargava. Kill your mother.
Bless me, father. Mother is serving you, is it?
Yes. She is nursing us. Without her, we will not live. If she is not here, we will all die of the pain.
Is the pain curable?
No. Death is the last point for us. This is not curable.
Then, as per Bhrugu's law, I have to kill my mother.
No. Please don't do that.
Anyhow, your struggle will not end until you are dead. So now, you have two choices. Allow me to give salvation to you all, or allow me to kill my mother.
We prefer to die. We prefer to die.
His pride in Gujarat and Gujarati culture flowed from his pride in his Bhargava heritage. But everything was not right with Bhargavas.
Bhargavas of Baroch marry Bhargava girls from Surat and Mandvi. But they don't give their girls to Surat or Mandvi boys.
Yes, Kanaya. I have heard about this. This is truly unfair.
It's ridiculous and it's causing lot of resentment. We Bhargavas claim descent from mighty Parashurama. But we fight amongst ourselves over trifles. So I am thinking of forming an association to bring all Bhargavas of Gujarat together.
Good idea. Okay. I got to leave now.
Okay. We'll see you later.
Kanu, what are you doing? I thought you said there are enough articles for the next issue.
I have. I am writing a speech now.
What? Speech?
Yes. I have agreed to give a talk on Hindu widows and remarriages.
Oh yes, I forgot that you have joined Social Reform Association.
We are here to great culture, Dalpat. But some traditions, practices have crept in.
That starts sapping our vitality.
Some tradition of treating widows is like living ghost is one of them.
Oh, Kanu, curb your idealisms. The exam which you are studying for is very tough. Very few get through at the first attempt, you know.
I know. It's tough mainly because there is no prescribed syllabus or textbooks.
Then don't you think you must be studying for the exam
instead of getting involved in all the social activities.
Don't worry, my old friend. I'm not going to fail this exam. I will hide in Bharoch for next 2 or 3 months and I will study like hell. Athilakshmi too must be eager to go home. I will go to Bharoch and study.
Okay, Kan. Study well.
Hooray! I have passed! Ma! Ma!
Yes, Kanu?
See, I have passed LLB exams.
Oh, good. Good, my dear. You fulfilled your father's dream. You are the best son. Have you told this happy news to Lakshmi?
Now I will tell Ma.
Okay.
Lakshmi!
Haji?
Now you are wife of an advocate.
Oh, is it? Wait, I'll bring sweets.
No. You are here. That is more than having a sweet. Next month we are moving to 3-bedroom house.
That might be expensive for us.
Yes. Rent is 20 rupees. Food and another expenses come to another 100. It's going to be another odd struggle.
Ji, what happened? Since a week, you are saying that you are suffering from stomach pain. Have you been to doctor today?
Yes. Today he gave me the report on my pain. The reason for pain is appendicitis.
What?
It needs to be removed. He has advised to go through an operation.
Operation? Oh no! This should not have happened. Will that be cleared after that?
Maybe. But what if something goes wrong on operation table? What if I don't survive?
Please don't talk negative words. All struggles will be cleared. I will light Deepam in front of God.
I can borrow 500 rupees or so. That I will need for operation. But what will happen to Athilakshmi and mother if something goes wrong? They will be on streets. Oh, they will be on streets. No! They will be on streets! They will be on streets!
However, the operation turned out to be a simple one and Kanhaiya was soon restored to his health. One of his relatives, Jamiyat Ram, who was a solicitor, had been impressed with his efforts to bring harmony among the Bhargava clan, now took him under his wings.
Kanhaiya, don't think people will come rushing to you to ask you to fight their cases. You have to learn the ropes, and it all depends on who you work under.
I know, sir.
Your guru should be successful and dynamic. And I know just such a man. Every junior would die for a chance to devil under him.
Is it Jinnah? I would certainly like to devil under him.
No. It's not Jinnah. Come, I will introduce you. He has just returned from England. So, he may look a bit strict and show himself as a high profile man. But no worries, Kanhaiya. Don't be so nervous. He won't eat you. Come, we shall go and meet him.
Sure.
Hello, Mr. Bulabhai.
Ah, Jimmy Bhai. How are you?
I'm fine, Bulabhai. How about you?
I'm good. Thank you.
This is Mr. Munshi. Kanyalal Mariklal Munshi. My nephew, whom I was talking about.
Ah, the great advocate from Bharoch, right?
Yes, sir. I'm from Bharoch, but I'm not a great advocate.
Please have a seat.
Mr. Balabhai, I have some work to catch up with. I will see you later, Balabhai.
No problem. See you, Jamilbhai.
Your uncle speaks highly about your abilities. And I am sure he is right in his assessment.
Thank you, sir.
But let me tell you what a senior advocate told me many years ago when I expressed a wish to work with him. He said, if you are useful to me, I will be useful to you. And I don't have to spill it out to you, do I?
No, sir.
Fine. Come here every evening at 6:30. And approach me only when I am alone. Okay?
Sure, sir.
Good.
They are planning to start an iron factory here. We will get more cases.
What did you say? Iron factory, country fellow.
What is wrong in pronouncing iron?
Iron is not pronounced as iron. R is silent in that. Juice is pronounced as juice. It is not pronounced as Jewish.
Oh. Okay. Thank you.
Yep. Yes.
Those who used to snigger at his pronunciation started admiring his English language later. He read and reread the judgments of eminent judges to understand the legal phraseology. He studied how Mr. Bhulabhai Desai and other senior advocates presented their cases before the judges. Juniors worked to get experience and to appear in court to get the familiarity of the judges. Mr. Munshi worked diligently on the briefs passed on to him by Mr. Bhulabhai Desai.
Oh, today is PK coming to visit me. I have no balance in my pocket. I don't know how Lakshmi is going to manage.
Kanaiya?
Hello, PK. How are you?
I am fine.
How is Burma?
You might have heard about the challenge by the Irish Buddhist or you Dhammaloka. Burma is in reform stage. Nationalist movement has begun.
Oh, that's a great news. We have to unite for the freedom.
Yes.
Hello, Kanaiya.
Hello, Kaka. Wait. I will be back.
Okay.
Manu, Kaka.
Kanaiya, how are you? How is Adilakshmi?
I'm fine. I need of some money. Can you lend me 20 or 30 rupees?
Okay. What is the matter?
Actually, my friend has come to see me. So.
Take this. Take care of yourself. Okay?
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. PK, you have come after so long.
Yes. Need to manage both career in Burma and family here. I'm going to Burma tomorrow. So I thought I'll meet you today.
I can't let you go so soon. You have to stay at least another week. Tell me more about Burma. How does your wife like it there?
She is managing there.
Good.
Munshi was always short of cash in those days. But he did not allow this lack of money to curb his generosity or hospitality to his friends. It was in the early months of 1914 when a Gujarati novel that was being serialized in a Gujarati weekly took the community by storm. Yes, it was Munshi's Varni Vasulat.
Did you read the latest episode of Varni Vasulat?
Yes. A novel written by Ghanshyam Vyas. Have the heroine Tanmani is in despair?
They too have been following Varni Vasulat Dalpat.
Yes, Kanu. Most of the Gujaratis are following Varni Vasulat. And all credits goes to you.
Credit for the story of Varni Vasulat goes to writer Ghanshyam Vyas.
Oh, Kanu. It is you. Why don't you tell them that you are the one behind this novel?
I am sure they won't like it. If they come to know, I am an author of novels. A lawyer is supposed to be serious and dry as dust.
Kanu, think about the other side. It may increase your value in council. Don't hide your actual face.
If I show my real identity, then I may not get cases.
then how to lead life? I need money. The 20 rupees I get each month for the articles pays the rent.
Yes, that is also true.
Oh, hello Kanaya.
Namaste Kaka.
How is practice going on?
Sir, he writes stories, you know.
I don't know. But I know one thing, that he is not paying attention to his practice.
Sir, he has written Marni Vasulat.
What? You have written about Tanma? I thought someone had written it. I too had read chapters about Dumas many times.
But Kaka, I have also written Patani Prabhuta.
Is it?
It was only 2 years later, in 1916, when his first historical novel, Patani Prabhuta, was published, that the world came to know the real identity of Ghanshyam Vyas. Far from damaging his career, it increased his prestige among the legal fraternity and the Gujarati community.
Freedom is the birthright of every nation.
I would like to join Home Rule.
I'm afraid if you want to continue in my chamber, you will have to part company with the Home Leaguers.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Munshi, why don't you wear khadi?
Gandhi has launched his agitations there. Former Satyagraha Badoli. Gandhi, with the help of Vallabhbhai Patel, has transformed ordinary villagers into heroes.
I hereby sentence you to 2 years rigorous imprisonment.
Jai! Mataram!
He founded the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan.
Let noble thoughts come to us from all directions.
Mr. Munshi was among the 6 legal luminaries who were appointed to the drafting committee to give final shape to the constitution.
Mr. Munshi, will you go to Hyderabad?
Zakas, you know.
It is not merely commission, it is your dharma.
The Indian army rolled into the state and took charge.
The cost of cereals is very high, probably because of the Korean War.
Munshi took over the charge and temple was built.
I was very particular that Indian history should be written by Indians.
He lived for 82 years. The achievements are many, many.
Thank you very much once again. And I am grateful on behalf of the Bharati Vidya Bhavan for all those who have contributed in different ways to make this venture successful. I don't know whether such efforts have been made earlier, but if it is the first one, please do take this as a guidance and make it larger and add more life and lives to the system. Thank you very much. Namaskar.